Finally, the video you've all been waiting for. We're going to expose dropshipping and the business model in 2024. Because dropshipping doesn't work anymore like it did for the past 5 years. The market has changed, the consumer has changed, and the consumer also has become smarter. Consumers nowadays recognize a dropshipping store, and that means you need to do a little bit more your best to become successful with dropshipping. So in this video, I'm going to explain to you what you should not do with dropshipping and what you should do with dropshipping, because there are still a lot of strategies that work nowadays. However, you should just know them and know how to execute them. So let's jump right into this video. In this video, I'm going to give you 5 reasons why dropshipping doesn't work anymore. I will also give you the best dropshipping strategy in 2024. And of course, as you know me, I will give you a tiny bonus by the end of this video. Now, first things first, 5 reasons why dropshipping doesn't work anymore. And I think the first is very clear if you know me and my channel, that the reason is Shopify. And why? It's because Shopify is a very big risk. If you start a dropshipping store and dropshipping is your core business, then you want to be safe and not get blocked for some sketchy reason. And Shopify has the ability to block your store without a notice of default and without any reason. This can mean that yesterday you could have made thousands of euros in sales, and today Shopify thinks that you're somehow need to be blocked and you have zero revenue. So this to me is a high risk if e-commerce or dropshipping is your core business, and you should not use Shopify. Instead, you should use WooCommerce. And WooCommerce does not have the ability to block you. On the contrary, you will own everything that you will build within WooCommerce because it's free to use. So instead of starting with Shopify, start building with WooCommerce. Now, the second thing that doesn't work anymore is general stores. With general stores, we mean a webshop that like imports all kind of products with no clear niche, just like everything we like, we put into that particular store. And it makes it really hard to do marketing around that particular store because you need to pick one or two products which might be a winning product. But then again, when people come on your site, they see a lot of other products and they get distracted. And the only strategy that can work is being on advertising platforms. So it's really a hassle and a lot of work. And to me, a general store doesn't work anymore. Instead, what you should do is pick a niche. Because with a niche, you can specialize yourself instead of being a general store, and you can specialize your entire store around that particular niche, which will make it way more easier to market the particular product and store. Then the third thing is meta ads. And I know you guys will think like, what the hell is she talking about? Meta ads are working. And yes, I believe that they are working, but the platform has a lot of competition, and also the advertisements are becoming really expensive. So you need to have a very nice margin if you want to make still profit. Now, there is another platform which is working perfectly fine and which is slightly new, and that's TikTok ads. So instead of using everything that everybody is using currently and testing with, you can also think a bit of outside the box and use a different advertisement platform and not use Meta because everybody is using it. Choose a platform that not everybody is using yet. And also from TikTok ads, it's way more easier to grow organically. So that will also benefit your store. Now, the fourth thing is Google Shopping. And I see a lot of people like being very enthusiastic about Google Shopping. And I'm also really enthusiastic about it. But there's a reason why I think this doesn't work, is that I see a lot of people choosing Google Shopping, but not having the perfect price point. Google Shopping only works if you are the cheapest and if you have good product photos. So if you are not the cheapest and your product is too expensive within that particular focus keyword, then you should not be in Google Shopping, because people will click on the ad with the cheapest price and the nicest picture. So only use Google Shopping if you are the cheapest. If you are not the cheapest, make sure that your product will not be added to the Google Shopping listing. Now, last but not least, and I can't say this enough, AliExpress. Why does AliExpress doesn't work anymore? Because consumers recognize the products coming from AliExpress. Most of the time, it's a very cheap product with low quality, and dropshippers are selling it for 10 times the amount of what they're purchasing it for. So for example, if they purchase a product for 5 euros, they will sell it for 50 euros. And consumers are recognizing these products because most of the dropshippers are copying the exact same images from AliExpress into their store. So AliExpress only works if you make your own product images, or instead of using AliExpress, use European dropshipping suppliers. There are a lot European dropshipping suppliers nowadays. We, for example, collaborate with FidaXL, Big Buy, Matterhorn, and Vandermeer, and we're also adding new ones on a monthly basis. So instead of using AliExpress, use European dropshipping suppliers. Now, even though I have already shared some pros and cons, but also some alternatives to the reasons why dropshipping doesn't work anymore, there is one particular strategy I would like to focus on a bit more, because this is a strategy that is not often used yet, while it has massive impact on your sales. That is SEO in combination with blog posts. This is a new way of doing marketing without the need to advertise. It can be a strategy that can be, of course, additional to advertisement, or it can be used within an advertisement funnel. But what's the idea behind SEO plus blog posts? So what we often see is that blog posts are written about a particular product. And as you might know, a product will be sold based on a pain point. So if we feel something that really hurts us and we want to solve it, then we are looking for the problem in Google instead of the solution, because most of the time we're not really aware of the solution. So for example, I have had acne in the past, and that was a real issue mainly during my teenage years. So the problem I would then search for in Google is how to get rid of my acne. And the search term would be how to get rid of my acne. This is a blog post you can write if you have the product that solves this problem. So if you have a product that solves acne, then you can write a blog post, how to get rid of my acne. And there's a particular structure in how to structure that blog post to make sure that it will convert into sales. You will first have, of course, the pain point. You will let the people feel that extra particular pain they're experiencing. Then you will show the solution. You will show examples of other people that have used this particular product and therefore get rid of the acne. So we'll use social proof. And then we will walk through an entire funnel within the blog post to make sure that people get convinced that this is the product that will actually solve their issue for a lifetime. Now you can do this with all sorts of problems. So for example, if your gutter is constantly like full and packed, then you can say like, how do I empty my gutter? And you will have a product that will solve this problem. So think of the problem that people are experiencing and then think of the solution, which is your product. And that's why also a niche store is very important, because then you can write content evolving multiple content, multiple blog posts evolving around the entire solution and the entire product catalog you're offering. So instead of focusing on selling your product, which is basically the strategy with ads, with Google Shopping, you're selling your product there, instead focus on selling the problem and the solution. Now, I will create another video later on where I explain to you how such a blog post will look like. For now, I hope this is the way you can move forward with. And I will also share a template for a blog post below this video, which you can download from our website, woosa.com. And with that, I have also spilled the bonus already, because there is, of course, a structure, a template, and a design necessary to make this blog post as effective as possible. So below this video, you can download that particular template. And of course, it will be only for WooCommerce. So if you're not using WooCommerce yet, but you're inclined to switch after watching all of my videos and content, then the second bonus I have for you below this video is to download our free guide on how to create a WooCommerce store within 30 minutes. And it includes 15 video tutorials, which will help you getting there. Enough information to start with this new strategy, with this new dropshipping strategy. Hopefully you like this video. Please leave a comment below, a thumbs up, and subscribe to my YouTube channel to see more of these kind of videos. And then I will see you in the next one.